Hello and welcome back to our online course, Building Cost Estimation Simplified. In today's video, we will be learning about the method of measurement. This is the continuation of our previous video. Let's now look at the lesson objectives. In this video lesson, we will learn about the methods of measurement for brickwork, RCC work, and plastering. For measurement of various construction activities, what is most important for us to know is how to measure them and how to make deductions, and also what are the various units of measurement. To help us with that, we have some references. SP27 is a handbook of method of measurement and building works. IS 1200 is very relevant for people who are in the field of estimation and in billing. It tells us how to measure and how to make deductions for various items of construction. The IS code 1200 is divided into various parts and we refer to the following. For excavation, we refer to part 1. For concrete works, we refer to part 2. For brickwork, we refer to part 3. For shuttering, part 5. For plastering, we refer to part 12. Painting on walls, part 13. Paint and polish on doors and windows, part 15. And for flooring works, we refer to part 11. RCC work, this is what we'll be looking at in the first part of our video today. First, we look at the classification of items under RCC work. Generally, the unit of measurement is cubic meters, except for concrete, jelly, etc., where we use square meters. So, some of the classifications and measurements under RCC work are as follows. We have rafts, footings, base of columns, and mass concrete, which is for the foundation, which is below the ground level. And then we have walls with pilasters attached, plinth and string courses, fillet, etc. Then we have floors, roof, landing and balconies, chajas, shelves, lintel beams and brassemas, columns, pillars, piers and abutments, posts and struts, staircases in which the landing is excluded but the stringer beams are included, for spiral staircases including landings, balustrades, newels and railings which are part of the of a staircase, the arches, arch ribs, domes and walls. Again, they form either the roof or opening, either they might be spanning openings or mostly in the roof of the building we'll have these parts. Then shell roofs and folded plates, these are thin shell roofs which again span large areas and gives volume to the building. Chimneys and shafts, walls, well steening. Vertical and well steening is the load giving member in a well. Vertical and horizontal fins individually are forming box louvers and fascias. So it's so basically we have all the classification and measurement which come under RCC, curbs, steps and the like, which we use for pavements and for stepping, etc. String courses, band copings, bed plates, anchor blocks, plain window sills and like. Yeah, we might be having concrete, the use of RCC in window sills and similar parts, moldings as in cornices, window sills, etc. Encased rolled steel sections, and the reinforcement is measured in kilogram or metric ton. So when we do the measurement, when it is the case of length of beam, the beams are measured from the face of column to column, and the depth of beam is measured from the bottom of the slab to the bottom of the beam if beam and slab are not cast together. If they are cast separately, then the measurement is from the bottom of slab to the bottom of beam. If it is monolithic casting of beam and column, where the beam and column are cast together, except example in T beams or L beams, The depth of the beam shall be from the top of the slab to the bottom of the beam. Now, when we have sunshades and projections from wall, which is commonly called as chhajjas, the common portion of the lintel is included in the measurement of chhajja. So, when the RCC measurement is taken, this is also part of the chhajja. If this chhajja sunshade is an extension of a slab or roof, the measurement is made up to the central line of the bearing of the chhajja. Now we move on to brickwork. For measuring brickwork, the length is measured to the two decimal points, like 0.01 meters, and area is again two decimal points, which is 0.01 meter square, and volume is also two decimal points, which is 0.01 meter cube. Though the unit of measurement of brickwork is cubic meters, when the thickness of walls is half brick thick or less, we measure it in square meters. That is the unit of measurement. For square or rectangular pillars, again we have the unit of measurement as cubic meters. Same is the case for circular pillars, tapered walls, curved masonry, arches, brick tile works. Now when we have honeycomb brickwork, we use the unit of measurement as square meters. And additionally, the openings of honeycomb are not deducted. So we have some brickwork where there are spacing left in between. You may recognize the picture on the right. This is a very famous design by Laurie Baker, the famous architect. And so in this case, what we do is, one, we take the measurement of brickwork in square meters, and the openings of honeycomb are not deducted. Now let's look at the work classification under brickwork. When we have brickwork at various parts of the building, they are classified under separate items in the following manner. Up to plinth level, then from plinth level to floor 2 level, from floor 2 level to floor 3 level, etc. So where do we do the deductions for brickwork? Usually, we don't have any deductions for bearings of slabs, chhajjas, less than 10 cm depth and within the wall thickness. So if we have a wall and then we have some parts which come and meet the wall, and if they are of less than 10 cm depth, then we don't make deductions for them. And also when they are within the wall thickness, we don't make deductions for them. The whole brickwork is taken into consideration for measurement. Same is the case for openings of up to 0.1 square meter in area. These are not considered for deductions and the whole brickwork is taken. When the walls are below one brick thickness, it is measured in square meters. When the walls are of thickness greater than one brick thick and up to three brick thick, are measured in multiples of half brick. When the thickness of the wall is more than three bricks, actual thickness of the wall is measured. We know that there are various width of walls. You may be familiar with different types of brick bonds like Flemish bonds, English bonds, stretch bonds, etc. So the variation of the thickness of brickwork, the brick wall changes. When it changes, then the measurement is also taken in a different manner. Now let's look at the items of brickwork. These include, as in when we have a BOQ and then we have the specifications on it, then what are the items of work that are part of the brickwork which can be under the same item? So we have raking of joints, then we have preparing of tops of existing walls. If we have to do additional work to existing walls, then we have to prepare the top so that the join and they can be joined together more firmly, and there is a the wall is prepared before any new either even if it is for applying mortar or for having plaster, we need to prepare the top of the wall before work, and so this is also part of the brickwork. Rough cutting and ways for forming gables, plays at corners, etc. So sometimes the brickwork, the brick wall may not be exactly at 90 degrees. We might have a design which would require the brick to be cut in a manner. These will be specially shaped bricks, and so this can result in waste of bricks. And this is also part of the, this is also included in the method of measurement. We are able to see this picture on the side where the wall is not meeting at 90 degrees, and so the brick has to be cut and shaped into a particular manner. And this is also part of the item of brickwork. Plumbing to angles. Forming reveals to jams where face cutting on exposed faces is not involved. Holes formed for pipes fitting, etc. If we have some piping or some plumbing line to be laid, plumbing, some when we have pipes to be laid for plumbing work, etc. Those holes are also part of the brickwork. Building in holdfast, we know what a holdfast is. Holdfast is what holds the door to the wall. They are usually made of iron, and these are what which the, these are the parts of the door which grip onto the wall and keeps them in place. Building in ends of beams, joists, slabs, lintels, trusses, etc. Even wherever the when a truss meets a wall, there would be, we'll have to build it in into the wall. And so this is also considered as part of the brickwork. Openings for which no reduction is made. Pointing wall plates. Sills, lintels. Pointing for wooden doors. Pointing for wall plates, sills and lintels. Pointing for wooden doors and window frames. Some of the items in general brickwork are footings. We might be having brick footings, and so this is considered as part of general brickwork. Battered or tapered walls. So battered walls are walls which may be broader at the which are broader at the base, and then they come tapering. They come tapering onto the top. And then in these, in the case of battered or tapered surfaces, battered walls, the measurement is made separately in square meters and paid as extra over the brickwork. Eaves or beam filling, that's also an, one of the items in general brickwork. Then brickwork in chimney, pilasters, plain coping sills. Pilaster is a projection in the brickwork. Made of brickwork, and they resemble usually a column, and they can be ornamented. We have a picture of a pilaster on the side. So generally this is also taken into consideration under the general brickwork. The unit of measurement are summarized here. We have cubic meters for brick masonry. For walls of half brick thickness, it is square meter. For square and rectangular pillars, circular pillars and tapered walls, it's again cubic meters. For curved masonry, we also need to specify the radius of the curve that is being formed. Again, that's in cubic meters, and arches and brick tile walls are also in cubic meters. But honeycomb brickwork and brickwork which is ornamental in nature where there are gaps in between, the unit of measurement is in square meters. Now we look at plastering. For plastering, the unit of measurement is square meters. Usually when we do the measurement is made correct to a centimeter and area to nearest 0.1 meter square. For each classification of plaster work, the following particulars are used. We need to specify the mix of mortar. What is the mortar? Like, is it 1 is to 15, 1 is to 10, whatever the ratio is, we need to mention that in the ratio of mortar. The number of coats and thickness of each coat, we need to specify whether, how many coats and thickness are, what is the thickness each time that we do for plastering. For the nature of surface treatment, before we prepare, before we have the plastering done, what is the surface treatment that we need? I'm sorry, the nature of surface treatment. Now we move on to plastering. The unit of measurement of plastering is usually square meters. The measurement is taken correct to a centimeters and area to nearest 0.1 square meters. For each classification of plastering work, the following particulars are used. So when we are writing the specification of the item, we have to also mention the following. We need to mention the mix of mortar, number of coats and thickness of each coat, nature of surface treatment, how is the surface going to be, of how is the plastering going to be, is it going to be roughened, is it going to be having smooth finish, or is it going to be having some other texture. These have to be mentioned in the item. What is the nature of base? What is, before we do the plastering work, how is the base going to be? So that also need to be mentioned. We can see in the picture on the left, the base work before plastering is happening. The next is the curved work, conical work, or spherical work, and elliptical work should be mentioned, stating the radius. If there are work which has got a radius involved, that has to be mentioned in the specification. Then any special treatment of the base, that also needs to be mentioned in the under the item. Now, plastering on roofs, ceiling, and walls shall be measured separately. So these are not going to be taken as one item. These are taken under different items. So when we come to reduction of plastering, we see that up to 0.5 square meter, if the opening area is 0.5 square meters, there are no deductions. When the opening size is between 0.5 square meters and 3 square meters, the deduction is taken on one side. So about 3 square meter area, the deductions are taken on both the sides. Now what we mean is, if we have a wall, then it has got two sides, and when we have a small opening which is of up to 0.5 square meters, there is no deduction. So this could be small openings for shafts or ventilators, or maybe any small opening for services. So these are very small and under 0.5 square meter area. And for this, we don't deduct anything from the plaster work. Even if that opening is there, we don't deduct anything from the plaster work. Now the next one is a 0.5 square meter to 3 square meter would be usually the size of an opening of a window or a door. Normally a single door or a window would be falling under this category, and in this case the deduction in the plastering work is taken from one, the deduction is made on one side. Now about 3 square meter area opening would be a large opening, like a continuous window or wall which goes to a full height of the wall, and so in this case the deduction from the plastering is made on both sides. Before we move on further, we will look at some terminologies that will be helpful for us. So this is a vertical cross section of a wall showing a window. So in this, the window is located in the one side of the wall. Now the what we need to familiarize ourselves with is the terminology called reveal. Reveal is the part of the wall where plastering is done. And this is on the side of the frame of the window or opening. So the side is called a reveal. We also have sill, which is the bottom part of the window opening. Corresponding to reveal, when it is a door, it's called jamb. And in a window opening, we call it as reveal. We know what a sill is. And lintel is a beam above the opening of a window. So these are terminologies that we must keep in mind before we understand about the deductions that take place in plastering. So we look at the first deduction point that we were discussing, which is for openings which are up to 0.5 square meters. So it could be a duct cutout, and this implies that there are no deductions made in the plaster work due to the small area, so a small opening. So we have this small opening in the picture. It's a construction site. So we don't make any deductions in plastering in lieu of this opening. Similarly, we don't also make additions for reveals, jams, soffits, sills, etc. of these openings, and no addition for finish to plaster around ends of joists, beams, posts, etc. Wherever a beam or a joist is is leaving an opening in the wall when it comes and meets the wall, we do not make any. There's no addition for finish to plaster around the end of these joists, beams, posts, etc. That's taken as part of the wall. Now, reductions in plastering for openings between 0.5 square meter and 3 square meter area opening size. This is something that we'll usually come across. So, for this, 50% of reduction is made, and no additional payments shall be made for reveals, jams, soffits, sills, etc. of these openings. So, the sill, which is the lower part of the opening, or the reveals, which are the sides of the opening. For these, no additional payments are made when we take the plastering item. Now, for the 0.5 to 3 square meter opening size, which we said was the normal size that we will come across during our work, what we have to take in consideration is when both the faces of the wall are plastered with same plaster, deduction shall be made for one face only. So we have a case where the plastering on the outer side of the wall and the inner side of the wall are the same. So in this case, we only make deduction for one face only, because and this is the case where plastering is same on both the sides. We don't have different specification of plaster. Now, for the same opening size, we are talking about the mid range of 0.5 to 3 square meters. In the previous case, we saw about having the same type of plaster on both the sides of the wall. Now, when we have different types of plaster on both the sides of the wall, the deductions are to be made in a particular manner. And for this, we check first where is the frame of the door located. Now, and then we see where the reveal is, the width of the reveal. If the width of the reveal, wherever the width of the reveal is less, then that is to be taken for the deduction purpose. So when two faces of the wall are plastered with different types of plaster, deductions are to be made from the plaster on the side of the frame on which width of reveals is less. So wherever the width of reveal is less, suppose let's see, this is the wall and the reveal, say the framework is on, the door frame is somewhere close to this wall. Let's say that. So the reveal on this side is lesser. So for our deduction purpose, we will be considering the window openings deduction for this side of the wall. And so this is how the reveal of the window is important when we take into consideration the deduction. This is not just the case for different types of plaster. Even if one side is plastered and the other side is pointed, we apply the same principle. Now, let's say that the window frame is not towards any particular side and it is equal. Suppose the window frame is right in the center of the wall. So where widths of the reveal on both the faces of walls are equal, deduction of 50% of area of opening on each face shall be made. So in this case, the reveal on both the sides are equal. So 50% area of the opening on each face of the wall is taken when we are doing the plastering measurements, calculations. And when we do the deduction, we take the 50% deduction from both the sides. Deduction for opening shall be made from each plastered face of wall. So we are still in the category of 0.5 to 3 square meters. Suppose we have a case where one face of the wall is plastered and the other face is not. Full deduction shall be made from the side where plaster is done if width of the reveal on plastered side is less than that of non-plastered side. So even here, we again check for the reveal. If the reveal on plastered side is less, full deduction is made from plaster on the side where the reveal is less. If width of reveal on both sides are equal or width of reveal on plastered side is more, then no deductions shall be made. And when As a fourth type, when width of the door frame is equal to the thickness of the wall or is projecting beyond the thickness of wall, full deduction for opening shall be made from each plaster face of wall. So these are some of the principles of deduction of plastering that we will be applying. Now, what happens when the opening size is more than 3 square meters? Then we have the full deduction of opening. The deduction shall be made for opening on each face, but jambs, soffits and sills shall be measured. So, the plastering work of the jambs, soffit and sills shall be added separately, but otherwise the deduction is taken, deduction shall be completely made on both the sides. The actual measurements are taken. Now we look at the painting, whitewashing or distempering. The quantity of painting is the same as the quantity of plastering, and the quantities are measured in square meters. One of the important aspects to be mentioned in the item is the number of coats, and the deductions are also the same as that of plastering, so it is important for us to have a good idea of plastering so as to be able to apply it in the whitewashing and distempering item. The doors and windows. Door frames are computed in cubic meters, door shutters in square meters, but doors are measured in numbers or each also. They are an item that can be enumerated. In the item, the name of timber used, thickness of shutters, types of shutters and fittings and accessories to be used are also to be mentioned. The fittings are computed by numbers and EA. Fitting may also be taken under a separate item in square meter basis of shutters, or lump sum provision may be made. Holdfasts are taken separately under a separate item by weight or number. So items, accessories of the fittings of the door may be taken as a separate item, like the bolt and the door knob, etc. can be taken as a separate item. And holdfasts are usually taken separately as a separate item and are measured in weight or by number. So this is the holdfast which helps in securing the door onto the wall. For services, there is a for service works like electrification, sanitary works and sanitary and water supply works, which is a plumbing. And for services work, we have an approximate cost of 8% of the estimated cost, and for electrification also there is an 8% of the estimated cost that is usually considered. It could vary from on either side, but this is a general thumb rule that is followed. So with this we come to the end of this video lesson. In this video lesson we learned about the method of measurement and deductions for let's now recapitulate. In this video lesson we learned about the method of measurements and deductions for RCC work, brickwork and plastering. We learned that it is important to know how to measure and also how to make deductions from various items so as to be able to come up with our bill of quantities. Or even for billing purposes, this becomes very important.